And we can move on to the next one, end curses. Okay, so let's build this. Okay, so now I got this error when I was testing, and the way I got around it was to append or prepend a variable pointing to gawk, just as we did before in the cross compile tools, so the cross tools section. So let's go back and delete this so we can start from scratch. So if we this time add awk equals gawk before this configure command, so type that in and then append that configure command just like that, so it appears like that. So when we build it this time, when we compile, it won't fail. So now let's try the compile again. You see that's now successful, so we can install it. That's all done. So move on to bash now. So we've got this patch to run in first, and then there's some configuration that's got to be set. It describes why this needs to be done. And now we can configure. And these bits here where it mentions about tests, these are the tests that configure does to find out what the system's capable of. It's not the actual unit tests, which we're not running at the moment. So when config's run or configure is run, there are various tests against the system to find out what the system's capable of, what libraries it's got, and so on. And that's what this part is actually referring to. So now we can run make. And install it. the right one. And now we'll extract the next one, BZ2. So make some changes and we'll build it. And install. So next one we do is check. And looks like the similar sort of configure we had before, so let's search for that. There is a configure, prefix equals tools, build equals CLFS host, host equals CLFS target, and make a make install so we can just run that in straight away. That's all done, so let's tidy up and move on to the next one, which is core utils. So run the configure. Make a change and we can build it. Okay, and we can now install. And tidy up. So the next package is diffutils. So again, this looks like the standard configure, so let's look for that again. So configure prefix equals tools, build equals CLFS host, and host equals CLFS target, and make a make install, so that's okay. Okay, it's done. So let's tidy up. And we'll move on to file. Again, it looks like it's the standard build sequence, so just double check again. And we can fire that in. Okay, done. So I've just got a couple of changes to make for the config. Slightly different config command, so just run that in separately. Right, let's build that. And install it. And it's complete, so we'll tidy that up. So we move on to Gork, and again this looks to be the usual standard configure make install for this part. Yep. Okay, it's done. So let's move on to get text now. So we're not going to build a complete package, so I'm going to subdirectory, run a configure command. Okay, so now we just build certain components that are required to compile these three programs, these three binaries, which is what is all that's required for the tools part, the temporary tools. Okay, so the last bit when we install it is just to copy those three files into the bin directory, and that's done. Just have to remember to go back two directories because we went down into a subdirectory before we tidy up. Okay, so the next one is grep. And got a slightly different configure command here. So let's build this. And install it. All done. So tidy up and we'll do gzip now. So this looks like the standard build again. Some spaces in front of this, make it easier to see next time. Yep, that's okay. And that's done. And move on to make. And as you can probably see, it's a similar command again. So we'll similar set of commands rather, so we can just simply redo the previous set of commands we've done. Now we do patch, and remember what I said, there's two files called patch. The one we want is the one called patch-2.75, so if I press tab twice there, you can see that's the kernel fix-up file, or the patch set, and this is the actual patch package, so that's the one we want now. So we've got the same build, set build commands. Let's double check them. Yep, that's okay to go. Okay, that's done. So we'll tidy that up. Alright, okay, get the right one. And we'll extract sid next. And once again, recognizable sequence of commands, yep. Okay, that's finished. Clean that up and move on to tar. So we've got some configuration settings to put in and then we configure it. Now we can build this. And install it. Okay, so now we move on to text info. Command here is a Perl assignment, variable assignment. right, so now I can build it. And install. It's done. So next we do util Linux. So we've got some extra commands in the config here. Okay, so we can build this now. Oops, not like that though. Like that. Okay, and we can now install it. And tidy it up. So, the next one, Vim, like it says, it's not technically necessary to get the system going, and their argument is that it's handy to have an editor around. I'd argue yes it is if you've got no other means of editing files, but in this environment while we're building, if I needed to do any editing, I'd just switch to tab, go into the directory and do the changes there. So while I don't think it's necessary for this demonstration, just for completeness, I will install it. So I just noticed that the directory that this expands into is not the same as the prefix of the file name. So there's the package file. You see it's vim dash 8, whereas the directory that's been created from that package is vim 8.0 without the dash or the full stop for that matter. So just worth bearing that in mind. So now we're going to patch it and put some config changes in. Make one change and then we can run the config command. So now we can build it. that's all done, and now we install it, and notice they've got the J1 switch there to ensure that the install happens in sequence rather than in parallel. So there's obviously problems if it's done in parallel. Make a link to Vi and make a default configuration file. So now we're going to do XZ, and this is the standard configuration. So I'll just check it once more. Yep. Okay, so that's done.